5, 6, 7, 8, turn, touchdown, back step. 5, 6, 7, 8, turn, touchdown, back step, pivot step, walk. Last part is pivot step, walk. Viewing for the last turn. 5, 6, 7, 8, turn, touchdown, back step, pivot step, walk. Right. So the whole combination facing away from the mirror. From the top, a 5, 6, 7, and 8. One more time, boys and girls together. Don't kill yourselves, Mark. A 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, I'm gonna put you in your groups now. When I call out your number, I'll tell you where you're gonna be in the formation.
Oh, God, I don't remember my number.
Right. When I find a number without a person, it's you.
Okay,
girls, first, number 2, downstage. Number 9, upstage. Number 10, downstage. And number 23, upstage. 23? Judy Turner?
23!
Stage left, girls. Second group. Number 37, downstage. Number 60, upstage. Left. Third group of boys. Number 63 downstage, 67 upstage, 81 downstage, and 84 upstage. Okay, boys, stage left. Let's do the ballet combination. First group of girls, second group follow. A 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Deanna, you're dancing with your tongue again.
Sorry. Shit.
Next group, and hey, you in the back. Any ballet? Don't dance. Don't dance! Next group, and ballet?
What?
Any Broadway shows?
No.
Okay, the arms are second down fourth. I want to see it, okay? Again. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Next group. And hey, boy in the headband. Keep your head up. Headband, head up! And up! a favor. You dance upstage. You downstage. A 5, 6, 7, 8. Boys, 5, 6, 7, 8. Hold it, stop. Al, the step is down, step, pivot, step. Not pivot, step, pivot, step. You're chewing gum, get rid of it. You, it's step, step, up, cross, turn from there, okay? You got it? Again, 5, 6, 7, 8. Stay in the formation and tone it down, okay? Play in the headband, keep your head up. 5, 6, 7, 8. Shows? Broadway shows.
A touring company.
Okay. I'm eliminating Dan. When I call your number, please form a line. Girls first. Number 2. Number 9. Number 10. Number 23, Judy Turner. Right. Number 37. 149, 152, 179. And Cassie. Other girls, thank you very much for coming. I'm sorry. All right, boys. Number 5, number 17, 44, 45, 63, 67, 81. And 84. Other boys, thank you. Larry.
God, I think I've got it. I think I've got it. I knew he liked me all the time.
I want your pictures and resumes, please. And resumes, please.
Who am I anyway? Am I my resume? That is a picture of a person I don't know. What does he want from me? What should I try to be? So many faces all around, and here we go. I need this job. Oh God, I need this show.
Today, I want you to tell me your stage name, real name if it's different. And I'd also like to know where you were born and when.
Terrific.
Fabulous.
Excuse me, sir. Do we have to? I mean, it's not very polite to ask a lady her age.
Being polite doesn't interest me. Your age does. And I want to know your age. Okay, let's go down the line. We'll start on the end, stage right.
26!
Start with your name and step forward.
My real name is Don Kerr, Kansas City, Kansas, October 20th, 1949.
Next.
Maggie Winslow.
Louder!
Maggie Winslow! Sometimes known as Margaret, Margie, Peggy, all the above, whatever it's real. I was born in San Mateo, California on a Thursday evening at 10:40 p.m., August 17th, 1950.
Mike Costa, used to be Costa Falone, born in Trenton, New Jersey, July 9th, 1951, which makes me 24.
Next.
Connie Wong. It's always been Connie Wong. I was born in Chinatown, Lower East Side.
Your age?
Go on, Miss Wong.
December 5th, 4,642, the year of the chicken.
Next.
My real name is Sidney Kenneth Beckenstein. My Jewish name is Rachmel Lev Ben Yokov Meyer Beckenstein. My professional name is Gregory Gardner. Very East Side, and I do not deny it. Born August 2nd, 1943.
Cassie, Zach, can I talk to you for a minute?
Sure, go ahead.
Well, I mean privately.
Not right now, Cassie. I'm running about an hour behind.
Yes, I know, but this will only take a minute.
Next!
I'm Sheila Bryant, really Sarah Rosemary Bryant, which I really hate. I was born on August 8th, 1946 in Colorado Springs, Colorado. And I'm gonna be 30 real soon. And I'm real glad.
I'm Robert Charles Joseph Henry Mills III. That's my real name, too. I come from upstate New York near Buffalo. I can't remember the name of the town. I blocked it out. Born March 15th, 1950.
My name is B.B. Bensonheimer. I know, I gotta change it. Born June 6th, 1949. I come from Boston, and here I am!
My name is Judy Turner. My real name is Lana Turner.
No. It's always been Judy Turner. I was born July 21st, 1952. Oh, and I was born in El Paso. El Paso, Texas.
Good. Next.
My name is Richie Walters. I'm from Herculaneum, Missouri. I was born on a full moon June 13th, 1948. And I'm black.
I'm Alan DeLuca, January 11th, 1945. I come from the Bronx.
I'm Christine Urich, Christine Evelyn Urich, born September 1st, 1953. Oh, and I'm from St. Louis, Missouri. Oh, and my married name is DeLuca.
Oh, I didn't know, Al. Congratulations.
Thanks. You know, we just got back from our
honeymoon. Next.
Well, as far as I'm concerned, I'm Valerie Clark. But my parents think I'm Margaret Mary Houlihan. Couldn't you just die? I was born in the middle of nowhere, a little town called Arlington, Vermont. Bye-bye.
How old are you?
Old? No, 25.
Mark Anthony! Well, really, Mark, Philip Lawrence Tabori, Tempe, Arizona, 20!
Oh, Jesus.
And if I get this show, I'll work real hard!
Oh, brother.
Don't let them bug you, honey.
Paul San Marco, it's my stage name. My real name is Efrain Ramirez. I was born in Spanish Harlem, October 22nd, 1947.
My name is Deanna Morales, and I didn't change it because I figured ethnic was in. 61048. You got that? And I was born on a Hollywood bed in the Bronx.
Go on, Deanna.
Go on. What? Oh, you want to know how tall I am? Or the color of my eyes? Or how many shows I've done? Well, I just gave you my picture and resume. Everything you want to know is right there.
I know. Now tell me what's not on it.
Like what?
Talk about yourself.
Talk about what?
Tell me about the Bronx.
What's to tell about the Bronx? It's uptown and to the right.
What did you do there?
In the Bronx. Mostly wait to get out.
What made you start dancing?
Who knows? I have rhythm. I'm Puerto Rican. We always jumped around and danced. Hey, do you want to know if I can act? Give me a scene to read. I'll act. I'll perform. But I can't just talk. Please, I'm too nervous.
And relax.
Look, I really don't mind talking. It's just that I can't be the first. Please.
You want this job, don't you?
Sure, I want the job.
All right, Deanna, back in line. Before we do any more dancing, and we will be dancing some more, let me explain something. I'm looking for a strong dancing chorus. I need people who look terrific together and who can work together as a group. But there are also some small parts that have to be played by the dancers I hire. Now, I have your pictures and resumes. I know what shows you've been in, but that's not going to help me. I don't want to give you just a few lines to read. I think it'd be better if I knew something about you, about your personality. So I'm going to ask you some questions. I want to hear you talk. Treat it like an interview. I don't want you to think you have to perform. I just want to hear you talk and be yourselves. And everybody, just relax. As much as you can. Sheila.
How many people do you want?
Four and four?
44?
No, four and four.
Four boys, four girls.
Need any women?
Okay, Mike, I'll start with you.
Me? Don't you want to start at the end?
No, I'll start with you. And relax.
I could if you started at the end. What do you want to know?
What do you want to tell me?
I'd like to tell you to start at the end. No. I can't think of a thing.
Yes, you can. Why just start dancing?
Cause my sister did. I come from this big Italian family. My grandmother was always hanging out the window, leaning on a little pillow. Cause that's what Italian grandmothers do. They hang out windows. I was the last of 12. I was an accident.
Yeah, right.
I was. That's what my sister told me. Yeah, that was the sister. Rosalie. She's the one that started taking dance lessons. My mother'd take her every Saturday, and she'd take me along. I like going.
How old were you?
Four. I'd sit there all perky, and I'm watching Cisco pitter-pat. Said, I could do that. I could do that. Knew every step right off the bat. Said, I could do that. I could do that. One morning, sis won't go to dance class. I grabbed her shoes and tights and all. But my foot's too small, so I stuffed her shoes with extra socks. Run seven blocks. In nothing flat. Hell, I can do that. I can do that. I got to class and had it made. And so I stayed the rest of my life. All thanks to sis. Do this. everybody started calling me Twinkle Toes.
Did that bother you?
Nah, I figured let them say what they want.
I don't buy that, Mike.
Well, yeah, sure it bothered me. I mean, why should they call me Twinkle Toes just because I took a couple dance lessons?
Okay, Mike, back in line. Bobby, you're on.
Well, actually, I don't know how I turned out as heavenly as I did. You see, when I was 5 years old, I was playing jacks in the garage and the car fell down on my head.
Get the hug.
Are you gonna do a routine?
No, moving right along. Moving along. Let's see, do you want to know all the wonderful and exciting things that have happened to me in my life? Or do you want the truth?
I'll take the truth.
Well, to begin with, I come from this quasi-middle upper or upper middle class family type home. I could never figure out which, but it was real boring. I mean, we had money, but no taste. You know the kind of house? AstroTurf on the patio? Anyway, my mother had a lot of card parties and was one of the foremost bridge cheaters in America. And my father worked for this big corporation. They used to send him out into the field a lot to drink. Better that than to find him lying on his office floor. But he was okay. I was the strange one.
How strange?
Real, real strange. I used to love to give garage recitals, bizarre recitals. This one time, I was doing Frankenstein as a musicale, and I spray painted this kid silver all over. Well, they had to rush him to the hospital because he had that thing when your pores can't breathe. Now, he lived because luckily I didn't paint the soles of his feet, and
what if I'm next? What if I'm next? What am I gonna do? I haven't got a clue. I've got to think of something. What does he want? What does he want? Stories from the past. I better find one fast. What should I say?
Stranger and stranger. I used to go down to this busy intersection near my house at rush hour and direct traffic. Just wanted to see if anybody noticed me. That's when I started breaking into people's houses. Oh, I didn't steal anything. I just rearranged their furniture.
Orphan at three, mother and dad both gone, raised by a sweet ex-con, tied up and raped at seven, seriously, nothing too obscene, I'd better keep it clean. What should I say? What can I tell him?
School? You want to hear about school? I went to PS shit. You see, I was the kind of kid who was always getting slammed into lockers and stuff like that. Oh, not only by the students, by the teachers too. Oh, and I hated sports. Hated sports. And sports were very big. I mean, it was Jock City, but I didn't make one team. You see, I couldn't catch a ball if it had Elmer's glue on it. And wouldn't my father have to be this big ex-football hero? He was so humiliated, he didn't know what to tell his friends. So he told them all I had polio. On Father's Day, I used to limp for him.
And
try to become, you're getting overwrought. Follow a train of thought, that way you won't be nervous. Try to relax, only last a while. I'll close my eyes and smile. What should I say?
Saying, if you don't stop setting your brother on fire, we're gonna have to send you away. Oh, and I was always thinking up these spectacular ways of how to kill myself. But then I realized to commit suicide in Buffalo is redundant.
Okay, Bobby, back in line. Sheila.
Yes. You want me?
Yes.
He wants me.
To talk.
Right. What do you want to know about me first?
Why are you in this business?
Well, I wanted to be a prima ballerina. Oh, that light. What color is that? Do you have anything softer?
Don't worry about the lights, just talk.
Well, like I said, I wanted to be a ballerina because my mother was a ballerina until my father made her give it up.
Sheila, come downstage. Closer.
Can I sit on your lap?
You always come on like this?
No, sometimes I'm aggressive. Actually, I'm a Leo.
What's that supposed to mean?
It means the other 11 months of the year have to watch out. I'm very strong.
Maybe too strong.
Am I doing something you don't like? I mean, you told me to be myself.
Just bring it down.
Bring what down?
Your attitude. Tell me about your parents.
My parents?
Your father.
Him.
Your mother.
My mother. My mother was raised like a little nun. She couldn't go out. She couldn't even babysit.
Sheila, don't perform. Just talk.
But she wanted to be a dancer, and she had all these scholarships and all that. And when she got married, my father made her give it up. Isn't this exciting? And then she had this daughter, me. And she made her what she wanted to be. And she was fabulous the way she did it. Do you want to know how she did it?
Yes, but first your hair.
What? You don't like it?
No, let it down.
That's what I've been trying to do. Better?
Better. Go on.
Oh, how she did it. Well, first she took me to see all the ballets, and then she gave me her old toe shoes, which I used to run down the sidewalk in on my toes. At 5. And then I saw the red shoes, and I wanted to be that lady, that redhead. And then when she saw I really had to dance, she said, "You can't do it until you're 8. Well, by then I was only 6. And I said, "But I've got to dance." I mean, anything to get out of the house.
What?
Nothing.
What did you say?
I just said that I wanted to get out of my house.
Why?
The truth?
Sure. You're strong enough.
Well, let's face it. My family scene was, not good. daddy always thought that he married beneath him. That's what he said, that's what he said. When he proposed, he informed my mother he was probably our very last chance. And though she was 22, though she was 22, though she was 22, she married him. Life with my dad wasn't ever a picnic, more like a come as you are. When I was 5, I remember my mother dug earrings out of the car. I knew that they weren't hers, but it wasn't something you'd want to discuss. He wasn't warm. Well, not to her. Well, not to us. But everything was beautiful at the ballet. Graceful men lift lovely girls in white. Yes, everything was beautiful at the ballet. I was happy at the ballet. That's when I started class. Up a steep and very narrow stairway to the voice like the metronome. Up a steep and very narrow stairway. It wasn't paradise.
It wasn't paradise.
It wasn't paradise. But it was home. Mother always said I'd be very attractive when I grew up, when I grew up. Different, she said, with a special something and a very, very personal flair. And though I was 8 or 9, though I was 8 or 9, though I was 8 or 9, I hated her. Now, different is nice, but it sure isn't pretty. Pretty is what it's about. I never met anyone who was different who couldn't figure that out. So beautiful, I'd never live to see. But it was clear, if not to her, well then to me, that everyone is beautiful at the ballet.
Against, really, except each other. I mean, I was born to save their marriage. But when my father came to pick my mother up from the hospital, he said, well, I thought this was going to help, but I guess it's not. Anyway, I did have a fantastic fantasy life. I used to dance around the living room with my arms up, like this. And my fantasy was that there was an Indian chief, and he'd say to me, Maggie, do you want to dance? And I'd say, Daddy, I would love to dance.
Do, 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 but it was clear, do, 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 when he proposed, do, 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 that I was born to help that marriage end well.
That's what he said.
That's what she said. I used to dance around the living room.
He wasn't warm,
not to her.
It was an Indian chief, and he'd say, Maggie, do you wanna dance? And I'd say, dance.
At the ballet.
I would love to.
Okay, Christine.
Oh no, me?
That's what he said.
I don't know where to begin.
Tell him how you got started.
Well, everybody says that when I was little, well, every time they turned on the radio, well, I'd get up and start dancing. And, this man, he came around to our house, selling,
lessons.
Oh, and he was a terrific salesman. I'll never forget it. He put me up against the television set. It was one of those great big square things. And he turned me around, he picked up my foot, he touched it to the back of my head, and said, this little girl could be a star. Well, I don't know if it was the look on my face or the fact that I wouldn't let go of his leg. But my mother, I mean, she saw how much it meant to me. I mean, I watched everything on television that had dancing on it. Especially, every Sunday, it was a...
Ed Sullivan!
Right! Ed Sullivan! Every Sunday, like church! And, oh dear, what was I talking about?
Ed Sullivan!
No, it was a...
Ed Sullivan.
Right! Ed Sullivan! I'm sorry, it's just, I'm really nervous.
That's all right, just take a minute and pull yourself together.
Faha, this is together.
He's right. Anyways, I always knew what I wanted to do. I wanted to be like all those people in the movies. Only it's funny, I never wanted to be Ann Miller. I wanted to be Doris Day. Only I had this little,
problem.
See, I really couldn't sing. I could never really sing. What I couldn't do was...
sing.
I have trouble with that.
Note.
It goes all around my...
note.
It's a terrifying...
thing.
See, I really couldn't hear which note was lower or was...
higher.
Which is why I'd disappear if someone said, let's start a...
choir.
Hey, when I begin to...
street.
It's a cross between a...
street.
And a quiver and a...
groan.
It's a little like a...
groan.
Or the record player.
Groan.
What it doesn't have is...
groan.
Oh, I know what you're thinking. What a crazy...
ding-a-ling.
See, I really couldn't...
sing.
I could never really...
sing.
What I couldn't do was...
sing. Three blind mice.
Three blind mice. It isn't intentional.
Well, she's doing her best. Jingle bells, jingle bells.
Jingle bells, jingle bells. It really blows my mind.
She gets depressed.
But what I lack in pitch, I sure make up in
power.
And all my friends say I am perfect for the shower. Still, I'm terrific at it.
Dance.
Guys are coming in.
Dance.
I'm a birdie on it.
Wing.
But when I begin to
chirp,
they say who's the little
twerp.
Go with Pong instead of
ping.
Oh. And when Christmas comes and all my friends go
caroling,
it is so disheartening.
Ming.
It is so disquiet.
King.
It is so discouraged.
Jing.
Darling, please stop answer.
Ring.
See, I really couldn't
sing.
I could never really
sing.
What I couldn't do was
do re mi fa sol la ti do.
Okay, Alan, Christine, back in line. Mark.
Well, I get the feeling that most of you always knew what you wanted to do. Me, I didn't. I was just a kid for a while. Oh, then one day, well, my father had this fabulous library in the back of the house. And when I was about 11, I guess, I found this medical textbook. It had pictures of the male and female anatomy. Well, I thought that was pretty interesting. I used to read that book a lot.
Were you interested in medicine, or were you just into the pictures?
No, I was...
Hello, 12.
Diagnosed my own appendicitis. Next day I went to our doctor down the block, sure enough, acute appendicitis. They rushed me right to the hospital. Well, I figured this book would cover everything the rest of my life. And when I was 13, I had my first wet dream. I went right back to the book. Milky discharge, milky discharge, milky discharge. Gonorrhea! I was in shock, I mean, gonorrhea! Before I'd even started, I was terrified. I couldn't tell my mother that I had gonorrhea. So the book said drink a lot of water.
Is that all the book said?
No, it said take penicillin, strepto something or other. But I couldn't do anything about that unless I told somebody. So all I could do was drink the water. And I drank like 20 glasses a day for 3 weeks. I almost drowned. Finally, I went to confession and told the priest that I had gonorrhea. Well, he was in shock, too.
Who have you been with, my son?
Nobody. Nobody.
Then how can you have gonorrhea?
I told him about the book's diagnosis on milky discharge, and he set me straight. It's the only time the church ever helped me out. Well, I was.
4'10", 4'10". That's the story of my life. I remember when everybody was my size. Boy, was that great! But then everybody started moving up, and there I was, stuck at 4'10", 4'10". But I kept hoping and praying. I used to hang from the parallel bars by the hour, hoping I'd stretch just an inch more. I was into dancing then, and I was good. I wanted so much to grow up to be a prima ballerina. And then I went out 4 chairs later, and they told me, no dice. You'll get lost in the football field. The pom-poms are bigger than you. I spent my whole childhood waiting to grow. Tits! When am I gonna grow tits?
Secret. My whole life was a secret.
One little fart! And they called me stinky for 3 years!
I'm gonna be a movie star.
But you see, the only thing about me that drew was my desire. I was never gonna be Maria Tall Chief. I was just this peanut on point. That was my whole trip, my size. It still is. God, my last show, I was 32 and I played a 14-year-old brat.
Aha, you're the chicken. 32?
Oh, so I got caught. But I don't look it, and I should not get, because I've always been able to work.
From the time I was five in King and I, King and I. Up to now, I've never stopped, cause whatever I am, I am.
So excited, cause I'm gonna go to the High School for Performing Arts. I mean, I was dying to be a serious actress. Anyway, it's the first day of acting class and we're in the auditorium. And the teacher, Mr. Karp, Mr. Karp. Anyway, he puts us up on the stage with our legs around each other, one in back of the other, and he says, okay, we're going to do improvisations. Now you're on a bobsled and it's snowing out and it's cold. Okay, go. Every day for a week we would try to feel the motion. Feel the motion down the hill. Every day for a week we would try to hear the wind rush. Hear the wind rush. Feel the chill. And I dug right down to the bottom of my soul to see what I had inside. Yes, I dug right down to the bottom of my soul and I tried. I tried. And everybody's going, whoosh, whoosh. I feel the snow. I feel the cold. I feel the air. And Mr. Karp turns to me and he says, okay, Morales, what did you feel? And I said, nothing, I'm feeling nothing. And he says nothing could get a girl transferred. They all felt something, but I felt nothing except the feeling that this bullshit was absurd. But I said to myself, hey, it's only the first week. Maybe it's genetic. They don't have bobsleds in San Juan. Second week, more advanced than we had to be. Be a sports car ice cream cone. Mr. Karp, he would say, very good, except Morales. Try Morales all alone. So I dug right down to the bottom of my soul to see how an ice cream felt. Yes, I dug right down to the bottom of my soul. Never. Jesus Christ! Went to church, praying Santa Maria, send me guidance, send me guidance on my knees. Went to church, praying Santa Maria, help me feel it, help me feel it, pretty please. Then a voice from down at the bottom of my soul came up to the top of my head, and a voice from dug right down to the bottom of my soul and cried, cause I felt nothing.
I turned 15, I lied about my age so I could join AGVA. You know, the nightclub union. Cause I could make $60 a week working these strip joints outside of Kansas City.
I worked this one club for about 8 weeks straight, and I really became friendly with this stripper. Her name was Lola Latours, and her dynamic twin 44s. Well, she really took to me. I mean, we did share the only dressing room, and she did a lot of dressing. Anyway, she used to come and pick me up and drive me to work nights. Well, the neighbors would all be hanging outside of their windows, and she'd drive up in her big, big Cadillac convertible and smile. And I'd come tripping out of the house with my little tuxedo and my tap shoes in my hand, and we'd go driving down the block with her long, flaming red hair just blowing in the wind.
513, hello,
love. Why do I pay for it?
Could be a movie star, then I could be a movie star.
Well, when the guys on the block saw Lola, they all wanted to know what the story was. And I told them about this big, hot romance we were having, but actually she was going with this.
Little brat, that's what my sister was, a little brat. So when she came to pick me up at school with all those great big yellow rollers in her hair, no matter how much I begged her, and she'd say, "What? Are you ashamed of your own mother?" But the thing that made my daddy laugh so much was when I used to jump and dance around the living room. Please take this message to mother.
Father's side of the family, the ugly side.
Wait until your father gets home.
Swear to God and hope to die.
And it was the first time I'd ever seen a dead body. But then when I was 15, the most terrible thing happened. The 10 Mac Amateur Hour held auditions in St. Louis, and I didn't hear about it till after they'd gone, and I nearly killed myself. Nearly killed myself. I tried to walk in front of a speeding streetcar. She was my best girlfriend. Didn't any of you ever practice kissing with another girl? So that when the time came, you'd know how to. No? Oh my God! Hi, Tootie. Did you, girl?
Yeah, but just a couple of times.
Oh, count me in.
Oh, thank God. Anyway, I do remember.
The worst thing in school was every time the teacher would call on me, I'd be hard. Really, I have to lean up against the desk like this. And the teacher would say, "Stand up straight." I can't, I have a pain in my side. Stand up straight. We're walking down the hall. You'd have to walk like this.
With all your books stacked up in front of you.
I thought it was just me. I thought I was a sex maniac.
You are.
I
started to. I mean, it didn't go down for 3 years.
And the bus. The bus was the worst. I just look at a bus and bingo! Then there's the time I was in the back seat making out with Sally Ketcherman. We were necking and I was feeling her boobs and feeling her boobs. And after about an hour or so, she said, oh, don't you want to feel anything else? And I suddenly thought to myself, no, I don't.
Did that come as a surprise to you?
Yeah, I guess. It was probably the first time I realized I was a homosexual. And I got kind of surprised because I thought being gay meant being a bum the rest of my life. And I said, gee, I'll never get to wear nice clothes. And I was really into clothes. I had a fabulous pair of powder blue and gabardine pink pants. A giant scarf.
Imagine me, this kindergarten teacher. I thought,
what
am I gonna be when you get shoved out of there, baby? Nobody's gonna be a fatty there with no scholarship to life. I was scared.
Goodbye.
kissed the folks goodbye, got on a Trailways bus, and headed for the Big Bad Apple. June Allison, right? 'Cause I was going to be a Rockette. Oh yeah, let's get one thing straight. See, I never heard of the Red Shoes. I never saw the Red Shoes. I didn't give a fuck about the Red Shoes. I decided to be a Rockette because this girl in my hometown, Luella Heiner, had actually gotten out and made it to New York, and she was a Rockette. Well, she came home one Christmas to visit, and they gave her a parade. A goddamn parade. I had to twirl a friggin' baton for 2 hours in the rain. Unfortunately, though, she got knocked up over Christmas. Merry Christmas! And never made it back to Radio City. Well, that was my plan. New York, New York, here I come! Only I had one minor problem, see? I was ugly as sin. Oh, I was ugly, skinny, homely, unattractive, and flat as a pancake. Get the picture? Anyway, I get off this bus in my little white shoes, my little white tights, my little white dress, my little ugly face, and my long red hair, which was natural then. I looked like a fucking nurse. I had $87 in my pocket and 7 years of tap and acrobatics. I could do a 180-degree split and come up tapping the Morse code. Well, I figured with talent like that, the mayor would be waiting for me at Port Authority. Wrong. I had to wait 6 months for an audition. Well, finally, the big day came and I show up at the music hall with my red patent leather tap shoes and I do my little tap routine. And this man says to me, "Can you do fan kicks?" Well, sure, I could do terrific fan kicks, but they weren't good enough. Of course, what he was trying to tell me was it was the way I looked and not the fan kicks. So I said, "Fuck you, Radio City and the Rockettes. I'm going to dance on Broadway." Well, Broadway, same story. Every audition. I mean, I dance rings around girls and find myself in the alley with the other rejects. But after a while, I caught on. I mean, I had eyes. I saw what they were hiring. I also swiped my dance card once after an audition. And on a scale of 10, they gave me for dance, 10. For looks, 3. Well, dance 10, looks 3. And I'm still on unemployment. Dancing for my own enjoyment. That ain't it, kid. That ain't it, kid. Dance 10, looks 3. It's like to die. Left the theater and call the doctor for my appointment to buy tits and ass. Bought myself a fancy pair. Tightened up the derriere. Did the nose with it. All that goes with it. Tits and ass. Had the bingo bongos done. Suddenly I'm getting nosh. Tits and ass won't get your jobs unless they're yours. Didn't cost a fortune either. Didn't hurt my sex life either. Flat and sassy, I would get those strays and losers. Beggars really can't be choosers. That ain't it, kid. That ain't it, kid. Fix the chassis. How do you do? Life turned into an endless medley of G. It had to be you. Why tits and ass? Where the cupboard once was bare, now you're not and someone's there. You have got him, hey, top to bottom, hey. It's a gas, just a dash of silicone, shaking you maracas and you're fine. Tits and ass can change your life. They sure change mine. You're all looking at my tits now, aren't you?
They aren't very big.
I heard that, you bitch. I didn't want them like yours. I wanted them in proportion.
Well, you got what you paid for.
I wouldn't mind having just one of yours.
Then go out and buy them. Have it all done. Honey, take my word. Grab a cab, come on. come see the wizard on Park and 73rd. Orchestra and balcony. What they want is what you see. Keep the best of you, do the rest of you. Pits or class, I have never seen it fail. Debutante or chorus girl or what?
Paul?
Sir?
Would you step out of line? When did you start dancing, Paul?
Not until very late.
Why?
I don't know why, I just didn't.
Well, what did you do?
Nothing much.
Oh, come on, Paul, you must have done something. How old were you when you did start dancing?
16.
Well, what did you do up until the time you were 16? I mean, what was your family like?
We were close.
Oh, close? Brothers? Sisters?
Two sisters. One died when I was 14.
How?
I really don't want to talk about that. I mean, why do I have to talk about that?
Larry, can we please sit down?
Zach, can the kids sit down now?
And smoke? Can the adults please smoke?
All right, everybody take a break. Out in the hall. Paul? We'll try this again later. Cassie? Stay on stage, please.
This audition's really interesting, isn't it?
Yeah. What are you doing here?
What do you think? I need a job.
In the chorus?
Well, look, Zach, I'd love a part, of course. But I'll take what I can get.
You're too good for the chorus, Cassie.
Too good? I did a couple of dance parts, so what?
Oh, you were featured. You stopped two shows cold. Your career was going fine here in New York.
I can't get a job, Zach. You sound like all my friends, my fans, acting like I'm a star and don't know it when the truth is I never even came close, but nobody has the guts to tell me. Well, it would be nice to be a star, but I'm not. I'm a dancer. Give me somebody to dance for. Give me somebody to show. Let me wake up in the morning to find I have somewhere exciting to go.
So you're going through a slow period. Happens to everybody. Something will happen.
That's what I kept telling myself in California. And I kept telling myself that and telling myself that. Well, nothing will happen. I can't act.
What?
I can't act. And there I am in California, supposed to be this actress. Well, it didn't take me very long to figure out I can't act. It didn't take Hollywood very long either.
You didn't work out there?
Oh, sure. A rotten part in a so-so film. The part ended up getting cut, thank God. I was a go-go dancer in a TV movie of the week. Let's see. Oh, commercials! I almost got to squeeze a roll of toilet paper, but I lost out in the finals. Isn't that something? 17 years in the business, and I end up flunking toilet paper squeezing. I was a dancing band-aid, that was fun. We had an earthquake. I got a terrific tan. Oh, and Shirley, you must have heard about that.
Yeah, I did hear you were going out with some big agent. Being a bit wild, running around, carrying on.
Well, when you're a woman of leisure, what else is there to do but get a bit wild and run around? Not to mention getting fat and going crazy, which is why I came back to New York and which is why I'm here today, Zach, old dear. Little pussycat. I need a job. To have something that I can believe in. To have someone to be. Use me, choose me.
I just can't see you dancing in the chorus, Cassie.
Why not?
Listen, if you need some money, call my business manager.
Well, sure, I need money. Who doesn't? But I don't need a handout. I need a job. I need a job, and I don't know any other way to say it. Do you want me to say it again?
No.
Fine. Then we got that far. Look. I haven't worked in 2 years, not really. There's nothing left for me to do, so I'm putting myself on the line. Yes, I'm putting myself on your line. I don't want to wait on tables, and what I really don't want to do is to teach other people to do what I should be doing myself. God, I'm a dancer dances. Give me somebody to dance with. Give me a place to fit in. Help me return to the world of the living by showing me how to begin. To come through. All I ever needed was the music and the mirror and the chance to dance for you. Give me a job and you'll instantly get me involved. If you give me a job, then the rest of the crap will get solved. Put me to work, you would think that.
You can't go back to the chorus, Cass. That's not the answer.
I'm not trying to go back. I'm trying to start over again, Zach. I'll settle for that. Starting over.
Starting over? We can't start what? Over.
We... Why, you're talking about...
No, I'm not.
Yes, you are. You're talking about us.
Cassie! Let's just keep this business, all right?
Well, by all means. I mean, that's what it's all about, isn't it? Work, Zach. Well, that's why I'm here today, about work.
You shouldn't have come. You don't fit in. You don't dance like anybody else. You don't know how.
But I did years ago, and I can do it again. You're not even letting me try. Please, just give me a chance.
Excuse me. Do you want the kids back now?
No. Take them down to the basement and teach them the lyric to that number. Oh, and send Paul in. All right. Go with Larry and learn the lyric.
Thank you.
You wanted to see me?
Oh, yes, Paul. I really like the way you dance. No, I mean it. So I figured we'd try this again. For one thing, if you're gonna change your name, why go from a Puerto Rican name to an Italian one?
Because I don't look it. People say you don't look Puerto Rican. You don't look Puerto Rican, but I am.
So you figured you looked Italian?
No, I just wanted to become somebody new, so I became Paul San Marco.
Why'd you want to become someone new?
Why? I'm not exactly proud of my past.
Who is? That's what the word means, Paul. Past.
That might be easy for you to say, but
look,
can't
wait
say
a minute. What made you start dancing? Your parents?
No. What do Puerto Ricans know about theater? Now they have Channel 47, but then they didn't have anything. But my father loved movies, and he used to take us all the time. He worked nights, and he'd come home, and he'd take us to 42nd Street, and we'd come out of one movie and go into another and another movie. I don't know why, but I love the musicals.
How old were you?
7 or 8.
On 42nd Street?
Yeah, it was a trip.
Go on.
I'd have to go down front because I couldn't see. I wear contact lenses now. I'd go down front and these strange men would come sit beside me and play with me. I never told anybody because, well, I guess it didn't matter.
Why didn't it matter?
Why?
Listen, Paul, if this is too rough for you, I have your picture and resume and we can...
No! Okay. From seeing all those movie musicals, I used to dance around on the street and I'd get caught all the time. God, it was embarrassing. I was always being Sid Charisse. Always. Which I really don't understand because I always wanted to be an actor. I mean, I really wanted to perform. Once my cousin said to me, "You'll never be an actor." And I knew she was telling me this because I was such a sissy. I mean, I was terribly effeminate. I always knew I was gay, but that didn't bother me. What bothered me was I didn't know how to be a boy. One day I looked at myself in the mirror and I said, "You're 14 years old and you're a faggot. What are you gonna do with your life?" By that time I was in Cardinal Hayes High School. There were 3,000 boys there. I had no protection anymore, no homeroom where I could be funny and charming with the tough guys so they'd fight my battles for me like when I went to small schools. I like school, but my grades got so bad. Even if I knew the answers to the questions, I wouldn't raise my hand because I would be afraid they'd laugh at me. They even whistled at me in the halls. It was awful, awful. Finally, I went to the principal's office and I said, I'm a homosexual. Well, it was a Catholic high school around 1962, and at the age of 15, you just didn't say that. He said, would you like to see a psychologist? And I did. And he said, I think you're very well adjusted for your age, and I think you should quit school. So I did. But I really didn't want to. I couldn't take it anymore. See, when I quit school, what I was doing was trying to find out who I was and how to be a man. You know, there are a lot of people in this world who don't know how to be men, and since then I found out that I am one. I was looking for the wrong thing. I was trying to learn how to be butch. Anyway, I started hanging around 72nd Street, meeting all these really strange people. Just trying to make friends that were like me so I'd understand what it was I was. Somebody told me they were looking for male dancers at the Jewel Box Review. You know, the drag show. So I go down to audition. Now, from all those years of pretending I was Sid Charisse, I had this fabulous extension. I mean, I could turn anything, my first audition. And they said to me, you're too short to be a boy. Would you like to be a pony? And I said, what's that? And they said, a girl. What do I have to do? Show us your legs. But I have hair on my legs. That's okay. Come on upstairs. So I went. And they hiked up my dungarees and they put on a pair of nylon stockings and high heels. It was freaky. It was incredible. And then they brought me back downstairs and they said, oh, you have wonderful legs. I said, really? Terrific. So strange thinking about this. It was a whole lifetime ago. I was just past 16. Anyway, then there was this thing in me trying to hide it from my parents. That was something, because I had to buy all this stuff. Like shoes to rehearse in, earrings, and makeup. I would hide it all, my mother would find it. I told her, there's this girl in the show and she doesn't want her mother to know what she's doing and I'm holding this stuff for her. She believed me. Well, I was finally in show business. It was the assholeless show business, but it was a job, nothing to brag about. I had friends. But after a while, it got to be so demeaning. Nobody at the Jewel Box had any dignity and most of them were ashamed of themselves and considered themselves freaks. I don't know, I think it was the lack of dignity that got to me, so I left. I muddled around for a while. I worked as an office boy and a waiter. But without an education, you can't get a good job. So when the Jewel Box called and asked if I'd come back, I went. We were working the Apollo Theater on 125th Street, doing four shows a day with a movie. It was really tacky. The show was going to Chicago, my parents wanted to say goodbye, and they were going to bring my luggage to the theater after the show. Well, we were doing this oriental number, and I looked like Anime Wong. I had these two great, big chrysanthemums on either side of my head, and a huge headdress with gold balls hanging all over it. Well, we were going on for the finale and going down the stairs, and who should I see standing by the stage door? My parents. I freaked. I didn't know what to do. I thought to myself, I know, I'll just walk quickly past them like all the others. They'll never recognize me. So I took a deep breath and I started down the stairs, and just as I passed my mother, I heard her say, oh my God. Well, I died. But what can I do? I had to go on for the finale, so I just kept going. After the show, I went back to my dressing room, and after I finished dressing and taking my makeup off, I went back downstairs. And there they were, standing in the middle of all these. And all they said was, please write, and make sure you eat, and take care of yourself. And just before my parents left, my father turned to the producer and he said, take care of my son. Well, that was the first time he ever called me that. I can't go.
Zach, do you want the kids back now?
Bring them in.
Okay, kids, here we go. Everybody in.
Larry, get the hats.
Okay, we're using hats. Everybody grab a hat. Try to find one that fits.
Hey, let's review this. Same combination we worked on earlier. It also goes with the lyrics you just learned. Now, this is important. I want to see unison dancing. Every head, arm, body angle exactly the same. You must blend. Now, this is one of those numbers where you're back to star. You're her frame. I don't want anybody to pull my eye. Now, let's review it. Starting position is turn in third, hips and shoulders on the dag. Elbows up, chest up, chin up, eyes front. Ready?
5, 6, 7, 8, 1, change.
Walk, walk, point, 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 flick, stem. All right, let's try it again. From singular sensation. A.
Singular sensation. Every little step she takes.
Point, flick, step, kick, stop, change. Continue.
Thrilling combination.
Back, come down, lift, 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 change, step, and step, on the angle, step, and step, body square, back, down, step, point, make it sharp, body square, on the angle, back, cross, back, back, cross, step, step, full change, hat to the head, step, touch, step, up, plie, kick, plie, tip the hat, plie, tip the hat, plie, right, full change, kick, no hat. The whole combination facing away from the mirror.
Excuse me, but after the grapevine, does the hat go down on two?
Yeah, hat's on two.
But what count does the hat go up?
It's on five. Exactly. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Hat, no hat. Okay? Hey, listen, everybody, Larry has the exact style I'm looking for. It's very 30s. Everybody keep your eye on him. Let's do it again. Ready? 5, 6, 7, 8, 1, 2. Singular sensation.
Point
and
point.
Flick.
Step, kick. Hat to the head.
3, 4.
Lead with the hip. Follow through. Up, down. Fill the frame.
Elbow right.
Down, point.
Step, brush. 3, 4. Suddenly nobody.
Step, flick. Step, up. Step, and step.
Lunge.
Lunge. Slow.
3, 4, 5, 6.
Back.
Kick. Step, brush.
Palm up.
5, 6.
Back, back.
Lift. Oh,
curls on the ends. Ready? 5, 6, 7, 8.
Hold it. I'm sorry. I don't have a hat.
Hold it. Larry, a hat. 5, 6, 7, 8. One, change. You're late.
Singular sensation, every little step.
Straighten the supporting leg, Sheila.
One.
Don't pop the head, Cassie.
Every move that
Maggie.
She makes.
Maggie, make it sharper.
One smile and sigh.
Line with a leg, Cassie.
Nobody else will do. You know you're
too much plié, Cassie. Seven, eight, one, don't pop the head!
Combination, every move that she makes. One smile and silently nobody else will do. You know you'll never be lonely with you. No rules, one moment in her presence.
Got out of the chorus when you were 22. And what the hell makes you think you can go back when you're 32?
My sanity.
Cassie, you can't do it.
But I did it. I did what you wanted. I pulled in, I cooled it, I danced like everybody else.
I know you did. And to be perfectly honest, I couldn't stand it.
Oh, you know, that's your problem. Why? Because you're the one who took me out of the chorus in the first place? Does that make you feel like some kind of failure?
Why did you leave me?
So we are going to get into that.
Why did you leave me? I came home one night and you were gone.
Why, Zach, you noticed?
Oh, very funny.
You'd already left me weeks before.
Left? I thought we were living together.
No. Sharing the same apartment, maybe. No, I mean in the real sense of the word left, you left. You were in love again and...
I wasn't. You know I wasn't. I was directing my first play.
And you were in love with it and off in the only world that
Cassie,
we...
you know how important that was to me. Christ! If I could direct a straight play and pull it off, it meant I wasn't going to be stuck making up dance steps the rest of my life.
You were never gonna be stuck. You were gonna make sure you did it all. Direct, choreograph, plays, musicals, movies. I knew you loved your work, but you really get off on it, don't you?
Yeah, I guess I do. You didn't seem to mind it too much when we were working together. Well, it's only when we didn't that you had problems.
Zach, I did not mind being part of your work. I loved you, and I could have handled that. It was not being part of your life that got to me, and not being able to keep up with you because that's what you expected. I know you did. You were moving up, and you wanted me to be right up there with you. Well, I was a good dancer, but you wanted me to be a star.
Well, what's wrong with that? Why shouldn't you be? Why shouldn't you be the best that you can be? You know, when I got out of the chorus, I decided I was never going to allow
myself... That is not a decision. That is a disease. God, good, better, best, I hate it. How can you stand it? Are you going to go from one show to the next, rehearsing them all 24 hours a day for the rest of your life? You know, you're not even doing it for yourself. You're trying to prove something like I was. Because I was doing it for you.
Yes.
To please you, to keep you, to get you back.
Yes.
Well, I don't want to prove anything anymore. I just want to do what I love as much as I can and for as long as I can. But at least now I am doing it for me. Who are you doing it for? Sorry, I have no right to judge. Why are we doing this? I mean, we must be over this by now, aren't we?
I am.
Well, good. Then don't feel that you owe me any favors. Just treat me like everybody else.
Well, is that what you really want? Is this really what you want to do?
One of them. They are wonderful.
But you're special.
No, we're all special. And he's special, and she's special. And Sheila and Richie and Connie, they're all special. I would be proud to be dancing on that line. Yes, I would. And I'll take chorus, if you'll take me.
All right, who are we gonna hire?
I don't know.
Well, what do you want to do now?
Start matching them up. Do the tap combination.
Okay, the tap combination. A 5, 6, 7, 8.
God, when it's over, do I need a drink?
He's gotta know who he wants by now.
Oh, Jesus, do I have a headache? I'm not sure I can smile much longer. I should have been a singer. Well,
if George Hamilton could be a movie star, then I could be a movie star.
What am I doing in show business?
All right, everybody, stage right, please. I'm gonna put you into couples now. You see, I'll start with Don, Judy, Bobby, Christine. Oh no, girls work on the other side of the boys. Sheila and BB, stand by. Boys work upstage a bit. A 5, 6, 7, 8. Don, work a little closer to Judy. Stay on the beat. Judy and Christine, stage left, boys stay. Let me see, Sheila with Dawn. BB dance with Bobby. A 5, 6, 7, 8. Let me see some smiles. Not that phony cell smile. Wanna see that I love to dance smile. Okay, all right, everybody stage left. Now let me see Deanna here with Greg, Valerie, Mark dance with Val.
Smile, honey.
A five, six, seven, eight. Deanna, I'm not hearing any taps.
It's my sneakers.
Now let me see, Maggie here with Mark.
It's Mike.
And Connie, are you hiding back there? Come out here.
Tapping is not my strongest point.
And give me Paul. Other three, hang on. A five, six, seven, eight. A voice. Step stage of the girls. Connie, relax.
It's not your knee, is it?
Yeah.
An old injury.
Yeah, he had an operation on last year. It's his cartilage.
Get back. Give me some air.
No.
You should call a doctor.
Really?
Paul, who's your doctor?
I don't want a doctor.
Who's your doctor?
Call Sydney Rhodes, 595-7639.
Larry, call it.
That's Dr. Sydney Rhodes, 595-7639.
Just breathe slowly and try to
relax. You know, maybe you should prop something up under his knee.
Give me a dance bag. Somebody.
No, we're gonna...
Hey, here.
I think it's okay. I just twisted it.
Okay. Easy. You ready?
Shit.
Is that better?
Does anybody have a Dargon? A Valium?
I do.
Hey, somebody give me some water.
I will.
Gonna be okay.
Yeah. But out of work, huh?
Look, I don't think you should give him that. You don't know what's wrong. Please, I've had three already today.
Zach, the doctor said it'd be quicker if we got him into a cabin over to St. Joseph's Hospital than if he came here. He'll be waiting for him at the emergency entrance.
Right.
No.
I'll help you.
Good. Let's get him up. You ready? One, two, three.
Where's his dance bag?
Which is his?
Paul, I'll see you later, huh? Hey, call me from the hospital. What are you doing? You can't dance anymore.
Kill yourself.
No, really.
Oh, shit, what kind of question is that?
Real heavy.
Yeah.
I know, but what do you do?
Well, I'll tell you, because I'm getting scared. I love being in this business, but then one day it hits you. Okay, Ricky, you've been having fun now for almost 8 years, but where's it getting you?
A lot of people are feeling that way, and they're getting out of the business fast.
There is no security in dancing.
But wait a
There's
second.
There's no promotion and no advance.
Listen, if you're looking for that kind of security, forget it.
No, it's not just that.
So what then?
Well, I can deal with that, but shit, there's no work anymore.
Please, please, I don't want to hear about how Broadway is dying, because I just got here.
Don't worry, honey, it's not.
They're not doing big musicals like they used to.
Even if they did. Even if we get this show, it's gonna close someday. Nothing runs forever, right?
He's right!
We're gonna have to start all over again because the only chorus line that you can depend on in this business is the one at unemployment.
Get it, Richie.
But don't you want to do something besides just dance in a chorus?
Gee, I just want to get in one.
Well, I want to be something besides the quirky blonde second from the end. Not that I want to be a star or anything.
Hell, I do. Oh, who doesn't? Everybody in the whole goddamn country wants to be a star.
Okay, I admit it. I want to be the next Gwen Verdon.
But she dances.
I know. Don't you just love her?
But I want to know what you're going to do when you can't dance anymore.
Who cares? I don't care if I never dance another step as long as I live. I'd be happy just going to Hollywood and replacing Jill St. John. Oh, big fucking deal, right? Well, I can dream, can't I?
Yeah, but dreams don't pay the rent.
So, I'll find somebody who can.
Oh, that's what gets me. A girl can always get married, huh?
She didn't say anything about marriage.
Yeah, and another thing.
Oh, please, I don't think I can take it.
These bodies don't last forever.
I can't take it.
We're no better off than athletes.
Well, I'm sorry, but I can't worry about any of that now because I plan on kicking these legs as long as I can, and when I can't, well, I'll just do something else.
Right, so you get into acting. No, you'll love it. I mean, it's fabulous to find out that you can talk, too. That's what I'm into. I'm not very good, but I'm getting better. And I'll tell you something, honey, it beats busting your ass dancing any day. And at least when you're an actor, you stand a chance.
Oh, what, come on. Baby? There are a lot more actors out of work than dancers.
Oh, shit, that's theater. Listen, nobody got in this business to play it safe. And we're all here because we wanted to be here. And you're all acting like it's just another job, and it's not. So what are you all talking about?
Life. Darlings, it's tough all over. That's why I have no plans and no alternatives. Just get me through the day. One day at a time is enough for me to deal with.
Listen, we all feel the same way or we wouldn't be here. But I have a wife and two kids. As much as I love dancing and theater, it's all about paying the bills now and getting my kids through school. I have to go where the money is.
What are you gonna do?
I don't know. I'd like to stay in the business. Maybe stage managing or someday directing.
Hello?
Whatever, I'll just have to see.
I can't think of anything else I'd do.
Well, if we all had to pick another career, go on. Pick a career. What would you like to be when you grow up?
Young. I know what I'm gonna do because I know one night, whatever show I'm gonna is in, it will close, and I'm finally gonna be able to get off my diet. Then I'm gonna get into the car with my husband, go up to our 50 acres in Vermont, have a bunch of kids, dance around the kitchen cooking, and enjoy getting fat.
That sounds good, except the fat part. I'd like that, just not right away.
Listen, all I wanna be is just happy.
Oh, come on. Aren't you happy? Look, I sit around and get depressed and worry about all these things too. But then I meet somebody, and they say to me, wow, you dance on Broadway? How fabulous. You got somewhere. You're something. And Christ, I get this feeling inside. Because I remember what it was like to stand outside that stage door and watch all these girls come out with their eyelashes and their makeup. And I think, God, I'll never be that old. I'll never be that old. I'll never be old enough to come out of that stage door. But deep down inside, I knew I would. And God damn it, I have come this far, and I'm not giving up now.
That's what I used to say. I won't give up. I've got to be a ballerina by the time I'm 18. Then I found out I should be in musicals, so I said, okay, I'll be a chorus girl. But I've got to be playing parts by the time I'm 21.
Oh, no. Did you do that, too? Give yourself a time limit?
I still do it. Right. And then you're 25, and you say, just a couple years more. Well, hell, I'm 30. I mean, how many years do I have left to be a chorus cutie? 3? 4, if I have my eyes done? Well, I don't want to deal on that level any longer. So just lately, I've been thinking about opening a dance studio. I don't know. Am I copping out? Am I growing up? I don't know.
Who does? Listen, who knows anything? It's just something we're gonna have to wait and see.
Right. But if today were the day you had to stop dancing, how would you feel?
Kiss today goodbye. The sweetness and the sorrow. Wish me luck the same to you, but I can't regret what I did for love, what I did for love. Look, my eyes.
I won't forget what I did for love, what I did for love.
Before I start eliminating, I just want to say I think you're all terrific. You've been wonderful about going through all of this today. I sincerely wish I could hire all of you, but I can't. Will the following people please step forward? Don, Greg, Al, Deanna? No, I'm wrong. Back in line. Christine, BB, Sheila, Connie, Maggie. Frontline, thank you very much. Thank you. I'm sorry. Rehearsals begin September 22nd. We rehearse for 6 weeks with a 2-month out-of-town tryout. Our New York opening will be sometime in mid-January. Be prepared to sign a standard minimum contract with a 6-month writer. You'll be contacted sometime next week as to when and where to sign your contract. And I am very glad that we are going to be working together.
Singular sensation, every little step he takes. One thrilling combination, every move that he makes. One smile and suddenly nobody else will do. You know you'll never be lonely with you. Into a room and you know